Today, friends, I'm going to show you some slick skills to use Tinkercad custom fonts to brand your 3D prints. So let's get cracking. Friends, we are going to start with this project that I call the Sketch Tool Gator. When you make this tutorial, you can squeeze the back and the jaws open. It comes with a template that makes the project even faster, and today we're going to take it and I'm going to show you how to brand it for 3D printing. Let me quickly show you where the template is. If you type bit.ly/tinkgator, that takes you to the Tinkercad project. As you can see, it is set to copy and tinker, so don't forget the golden rule of Tinkercad: give a reaction before you copy and tinker. This right here would be the tutorial to help you build it. Of course, mine's built, so let's move right back to that project. As I mentioned a moment ago, I like to brand these. I give them away as what I call a Pisca print. So I hide them for people to find, and of course, when you find it, you get to keep it. And it makes climbing the stairs at Mount Pisgah just a little more entertaining. Now you can see here I branded it with the basic text. This works, but as you can see, it's kind of thin. I did switch to sans, that way it's easier to cut in and print. I also used Canva to make an SVG. I brought that in and then I trimmed it so that it actually followed the curve by using another sketch. I'll actually show you this real quick. If I ungroup this shape, you can see I have made a sketch right here that actually follows that curve. It was that easy. If we double click, we're in edit mode, and you can see I just made a bezier curve, and then I came down and made it so it would cut out. When I hit finish sketch, now you've got a better look at how it trimmed the large font. I'll hide this as well, and it made it fit the way I wanted. If we do show all and bring it back, I'm going to take those two and do Control G to group. I love using Canva text. You can get super cool fonts. When I printed this, though, it was not super easy to read, so I decided that wasn't my favorite strategy. Let me spin this around and show you where I added it here on the back. That was not my favorite either. Friends, if we look at this one right here, it is using the custom font text shape. To find this shape, you click right here, and if you type custom, it'll show up and you can bring it in. Notice when it comes in, it has a built-in font, but we can drag a file or choose a file to add our own cool fonts. If you want to see my full tutorial about Tinkercad text, I will have a link to it in the cards. You can also visit it by typing bit.ly/tinktext. I will show you one thing from the video real quick. If you visit my website, HLModTech.com, on the Tinkercad tab, of course, there's cool sketch tutorials. There is a downloadable file that has 8 Tinkercad fonts in it. Once you download it, simply unzip it, and that's what I'm going to use right now to add fonts to our project. So here's how easy it is. Simply click on the text tool, choose the file. I stored mine in my downloads folder. And right here is the Tink Fonts folder with 8 different ones that you can explore. And I'm going to just show you Rainier real quick. When we click on it, you'll see it switches the word text, the red lines. That means Tinkercad is computing it. And bingo, there is the new word text using Rainier. If I go over here to the name, I'm going to make this Shift HL. And I would not use this for this sort of project. Notice I wanted something that was more thick, and this actually is more complex, and it would not cut in as nice as I want. I can, of course, keep that font over here so that I can check it out maybe for later projects. And I'm going to simply bring in the text shape again, and let's try a different one. I want to show you something real quickly here. You can see that I have put a note that says Great Vibes. Let me show you why. If we go back to this font, notice it does not say the one we had anymore. So now I've got the little note that says that one's Rainier. This one, of course, says Great Vibes. I'm going to take this one and do Control D and bring it down. And let me show you the font that I used for this one. Once again, I'm going to just show you this one already lost its name. So that's why we add these notes. We're going to choose Montre. Once again, it is so simple. You just hit choose and find it in the list. After a moment, it'll switch. While it's doing that, I'll let you know that over here, we tried Shorelines. Once again, these would not cut in real nice. As you can see, this one is nice and thick, so it will. Here, I'm going to put the HL. Once again, this is the one I used right here. I'm going to show you quickly how I put it there. I'm going to put this on the chin. If I do C for Cruise, I can drag it right to that chin. This is what I call the living work plane. That way it lines up with that shape. Here I can rotate 90 degrees. Notice I'm staying inside this blue ring. So it goes 22 and a half degrees at a time. If I hold down shift, it goes 45 degrees at a time. Now it's lined up the right way, but it's crazy large. So I'm gonna do alt shift shrink. And it shrinks around its middle to get close to the location I want. Let's do F to fit view. You can see that it's not connected anymore. That's because of the alt shift. We're going to put it on the correct space by using W for work plane and then clicking on the shape and doing D to drop. I can drag it into place. I can use the arrows. Notice because of that work plane, up and down is really those arrow keys. This time I'm just going to use shift squeeze instead of alt shift. And it stays connected just like we'd expect. Now I do want to cut this in, so don't forget I made it a hole. I'm going to set my nudge to a half millimeter. And now when I do control down, it sinks in as far as I want to cut it. So that, my friends, is how we add the text. If I hit W and put the work plane back down on the ground, I did also select this, choose L for align, and I aligned it to the middle. Bingo. HLModTech, I just repeated that for each step as I branded my adorable little gator. The final step I want to show you is that when I sent it to the 3D printer, notice I did not group the shapes. This is one cool thing about Tinkercad. It detects the holes and it cuts them automatically when you choose to export. I like to export as an STL, and I put it in my 3D modeling folder, and I'm going to call this branded Sketch Gator. V2 and hit save. Of course, let's bounce to Bamboo Lab Studio, grab that brand new print, and check it out. There you can see proof that they cut in even though we did not group them. Real quickly, I'm going to use the 0.2 standard. Let's slice that plate. Check it out. It's going to take about 25 minutes. And let's print the plate. Simply send it to the 3D printer. And after a moment, it bounces to the device menu. Once it finishes downloading, we can hit play and monitor everything from afar. And not too much later, we have got a sweet little sketch tool gator. Once again, prints in place and completely branded. How cool is that? Friends, as I wrap up, I do want to say thanks to everybody that's chosen a YouTube membership. Of course, there are three levels you can pick from. Find the one that fits you best. Friends, I do also want to say thanks to my supporters on Patreon. Love how that group is growing. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.